Shalom, shalom, call halal Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. It's 1:44 p.m. Call halal Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai Bahashem Kakodash. Baraka thumb to all you sincere brothers and sisters out there that believe in this truth and truth and sincerity. I want to give double honors to the elders and apostles of the great millstone who taught us this truth and truth and sincerity. Peace and salutations to the hopeful elect scattered abroad. In this video, I'm going to touch on passport sisters. It says, passport sisters are being murdered in the Gambia, okay? Passport sisters are being murdered in the Gambia. And it's crazy because you had some, you know, called the passport bros, where you had men, you know, leaving America to go to other countries, you know, to find traditional women, you know, to find traditional women, okay? So you had a lot of so-called black men leaving, you know, America to go find wives in other countries. And because of that, a lot of black women got offended, you know, and took it upon themselves to try to do, being that anything you can do, I can do better spirit, and try to create passport sisters, okay? Instead of just listening to the men and what they want, because a lot of the reason why a lot of men left is because these women are not traditional, okay? They're not traditional. They don't know how to be wives. You know, they're combative. They, you know, they're pretty much demons, man. All right, they're pretty much demons. And in that, instead of them, taking heed and fixing that, they try to one up and go to, you know, create their own little passport sisters. All right, so now you're hearing about these so-called black women that are going to these other places in the world, these other countries, and are getting killed. Okay, they're getting murdered. All right, so I'm gonna let this video play. Before I go there, let me grab this. This is the book of Job, chapter 39, verse 17. Because the Most High have deprived her of wisdom, neither hath he imparted to her understanding. And these women, they think that they can be like the men and do what men do. You know, well, you're gonna realize that you need a man. You're gonna find out in the hard way that you are not a man. And you need a man, and you cannot do what a man can do, you know? So it's just crazy how these women are, you know, trying to, you know, pretty much do the same thing that the men are doing, and they're coming up short, you know, losing their lives over there, you know, trying to be masculine. All right, so let's go ahead and play this.
So you all, I come on to just react to a phone call that I received today. And one of my beautiful subscriber queen sisters, she was...
You heard her say subscriber queen sisters. What makes her a queen? Why do you think she a queen? Do you know what queen means? When you go into queen, it means a hussy. Okay, it's originally spelled Q-U-E-A-N. And it means a hussy, a prostitute. Okay, but these women don't that's like I brought it in the first scripture. The Lord did not impart wisdom or understanding to them. Okay, so they just say these things and do these things and don't know or understand what they're doing. Let's play some more.
Learn about some videos that she have seen concerning African American women dying in the Gambia. And it should be a concern, because guess what? It's true.
So apparently, black American women... Some black American women have moved to the Gambia and they've been murdered. That's what that video is about. Of course, she downplays it. She says they have died. But, you know, if you watch the rest of the video, I'll include the link. They pretty much were murdered. Okay. And there's a couple of things that I want to bring up here in relations to that. This whole idea of passport sisters. It's pretty dumb and dangerous. It's dangerous for obvious reasons. Women should not be traveling to poor countries. American women should not be traveling to poor countries without a man. Okay? Some of you women, American women, you've been brainwashed by feminism to think that, you know, you can take on a man physically and you don't need a man. When you go to these poor countries, you'll find out the value of having a man as a protector. You may find out the hard way. It may cost you your life. Hopefully not. The other thing I want to bring up is a point, but let me just start out with a small story. About a year ago, I made a Facebook friend. He's a guy from Liberia. I figured, wow, it'd be cool to have a friend in Liberia. Maybe we can be business partners. Then after, you know, it was all brother this, brother that, you know, how you doing, blah, blah, blah. Then about a year passed, and he wanted me to buy him a phone. And I'm like, I'm not buying you a phone. And of course, after that, he just disappeared. There was no brother this or brother that. The reason why I bring that up is because I think a lot of Black Americans who move to Africa lose sight of the fact that they mainly...
So you all, I come on to just react to a phone call that I received.
Salakia, it's in here. Let's find the rest of what he said. Here
it is. To get your resources. Because, trust and believe, if I took a million unemployed Black Americans and just dumped them into some Black nation in West Africa, the locals would riot against them, just like they did in South Africa. In South Africa, they attacked other Black immigrants who were there because they were a threat to their jobs. And these women, these Black American women who moved to the Gambia, I think they kind of they kind of lost sight of that, reality.
They don't
you're only welcome there to the degree to which they can get something out of you.
Right.
I mean, I hate to say that.
The problem is they don't operate in reality. Okay? The truth be told, they don't operate in reality. They in some fairy tale world, you know, Disneyland, you know, some, you know, fantasy, where they have these things in their mind. And I think that, you know, especially being coming from America, America affords you a lot of liberties that these other countries don't afford you. So these women leaving America to go try themselves trying to find men, which really they're going there to be whores, okay? You more than likely you had a man here, you know, and you left him because of argument or something, you know, and you going over there and then you get put to death, okay? You getting put to death.
Another example is some of these countries, I believe, like Ghana, Senegal. I could be wrong. They have these citizenship. Things that Black Americans can get. Well, you can only qualify for that if you make a certain amount of money. They literally said, if you're a poor Black American, we don't want you here. Okay? So that's all I wanted to say. Because when you go on YouTube and you see these Black people in Africa, they really make it look like it's like Wakanda, and you know, it's completely different than what they presented as in America. Another point is that most of these businesses in Africa are not even owned by Black people. So when these Black YouTubers go to Africa and show off all these cities and these businesses and these buildings, most of the time those aren't even owned by Blacks. Did you know, for example, that less than 30% of all businesses in South Africa are owned by Black people? The number one, the largest company in Africa, the CEO is a white man. So a lot of these Black Americans that go to Africa and glorify it, they're actually glorifying a new version of colonialism. It's like colonialism 2.0. But anyway, that's a whole different subject.
So yeah, you get the picture, man. You know, you get the picture. I got a couple more videos on the play. All right. But these women, you know, they ain't thinking too damn straight. And that's going to get a lot of you women jacked up, man, coming in the spirit, trying to be like the men, trying to be better than the men. You know, you were created to serve the men, not the other way around. So you about to find out. Let's watch this one.
Cosas. Me no me gusta. Yo no estoy pasando tiempo contigo porque tú eres una persona que me vive tirando muchas cosas.
I'll read it. Look, honestly, I'm spending time with you.
Yo no estoy pasando tiempo contigo porque tú eres una persona que me vive tirando muchas cosas en cara. Tu éxito y ese tipo de cosas, muchas cosas en cara. Tu éxito y ese tipo de cosas, a mí no me gusta eso. Honestamente, a mí no me gusta eso. Después que salimos de Santo Domingo, yo actué como que si todo estaba bien. Pero después que llegué al hotel, yo no aguanté y le dije que me iba a ir. Pues yo estaba incómodo. Cosas cambiaron.
Things changed.
Cuando fuimos donde mi mamá, Dije que el baño.
You said the bathroom. You said the bathroom, this and that.
Esto, que el baño, lo otro. El baño sí realmente estaba limpio. Todo empezó desde ahí. Porque siempre te pones.
Because you always step over others, right? It says she's a medical doctor and an attorney. These passport broads taking L's in the DR.
Por encima de los demás, tú eres un ser humano.
You know, when I understand either too is that you gotta think, man. These men, the passport bros, are going to other countries to find traditional women. Okay, which women outnumber men in any country that you go to. So they're going there to find traditional women. If you go to another country as a woman trying to find a traditional man, first of all, he's going to expect you to be a traditional woman. All right, he's not going to deal with all this extra stuff you're coming with. And that's what you're seeing in this video. All right, the women go over there thinking that they run the fucking party, that they run the show, and that's why they getting put to death. Okay, because in certain countries they ain't allowing that shit, man. You can't bring that feminism shit to these other countries. You America allows that shit here. They're not allowing that in these other countries. So what happens is you go over there and your ass don't come back. Okay? The person I met at the gym.
No, sí, en ese gimnasio. Yo pensé que iba a ser diferente. Hasta que
from who she ended up being, right? That's what they do. They'll put on a show. They'll play that game like they're this person. And when she really get to know him, it's a whole different person, man. Okay. Let me grab that real quick. Let me grab this too. Micah chapter 7, verse 9. It says, I bear record. I'm like, I will bear the indignation of Yahweh because I have sinned against him. So us men, the reason why our women are out of order and they don't listen and they give you a hard time is because we sinned against the Lord. That's what we did to the Most High. So now he's doing it to us through our women. What goes around comes back around. It says, until he plead my cause and execute judgment for me, he will bring me forth to the light, and I shall behold his righteousness, which is what right now we're coming into this truth, getting this knowledge and understanding, and we're getting that, the answers to all our questions. It says, then she that is mine enemy shall see it, and it's unfortunate that it has to be this way, but it's the way it is. And it started from Esau. Esau set the man and the woman against each other, you know, in this fucking slavery. Jim Crow madness, you know, Willie Lynch letter, you know, and because of that, they have our people completely lost and confused, man. So now the woman think that her biggest enemy, the black woman think her biggest enemy is a black man, you know, and a black man trying to, you know, really don't want to deal with her. You know, it says, then she that is mine enemy shall see it. And shame shall cover her, which said unto me, where is the Lord Yahweh thy power? Mine eyes shall behold her. Now shall she be trodden down as the mire in the streets. And that's what we're going to start seeing. You're going to start seeing a lot of these women get put to death. A lot of these women get judged horrifically. Not only in these other countries, but in America, man. You know, a lot of you women have a lot of hell to pay for, man. You done put men through hell. You know, you done got you. You know, it was a video I saw the other day of a woman. Of a man who was 26, I believe, and he says mom had been keeping his dad from him. Told him that his dad said he was a mistake. Whole time his dad was looking for him and was paying child support. Okay, so a lot of them have a lot of hell to pay for, bro. And the Lord will judge you for all this shit. And this and that, and that's what's coming. And ultimately, what we're gonna do is we're gonna start over again. You know, these a lot of people in America, a lot of you Jakes in America, not just the women, but even the men too. A lot of you are too far gone and you ain't coming back. Only way you're going to get right is if you get left. All right. Let's grab that. Bear with me one second. Let me find the scripture. It says, here we go. Ecclesiastes chapter 25, verse 16. I had rather dwell with a lion and a dragon than to keep house with a wicked woman. Okay, because these women, you know, you meet them and they'll be all nice and, you know, calm and collect, and you know, the moment you start getting serious with them, they turn into a total dragon. Okay, trying to bite your head off. And this is why the Lord is having to where these things are being, you know, talked about in these end times, because the Lord is putting truth back in the earth. And a part of that truth is, you know, not only concerning the men, but also you women. All right.
Yeah.
Play some more.
Tú tienes que saber que yo soy un hombre.
Now, listen to what this man said in a DR. Okay? You need to know that I am a man.
Y soy adulto.
And I'm an adult.
Y tú.
That's a woman who tried to treat you as if you're a child. It says, and you are in my country.
En mi país.
So you're telling me that you haven't come around for all this time because I made you feel like a...
Now, you see they're using the damn translator, man. So this is a bunch of madness. But that's continue.
Oh, man, and you didn't have the dignity to come to me like a man and tell me what the problem was. Instead, you chose to disappear and allow me to waste my money.
Now you see why he disappeared. The moment she opened her mouth, she's going off. Okay, so let's grab this. This is 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 9. It says, in like manner also the woman adorn themselves in modest apparel. She's not in modest apparel. With shamefacedness and sobriety, being in your right mind. Not with broidered hair or gold or pearls or costly array, which apparently she got the money. It says, but which becometh woman professing godliness with good works. Let the woman learn in silence with all subjection. So if the man is saying, it's telling you something, just listen. Just listen. You know, it ain't a damn rebuttal. You know, it ain't a back and forth. It ain't a damn debate. It says, but I suffer not the woman to teach, nor to usurp authority over the man, but to be in silence. And that's what she's doing. She's moving her hands and she's talking about, she's trying to usurp authority over that man. You know, and he said, I don't need your money. You know, they'll try to throw money in your face. When a woman has money, that's her money. You know, a woman will have money and the man will still be, you know, paying for all the damn dates and shit. It says, for Adam was first formed, then Eve, and Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in the transgression. So these women have been deceived, okay, by the serpent. And the main thing he deceived you with was that feminism garbage. Notwithstanding, she shall be saved in childbearing. You're going to be saved in childbearing, not how much you think you know. Not by your money, not by your college degrees, not by being a hot girl, not by being a career woman. You will be saved in childbearing. It says, if they continue in faith and charity with and holiness with sobriety. So if they continue in faith and charity with holiness and sobriety, being of a sound mind, which these women are not. They like I said, they live in a fantasy world. Let's play some more.
Be by myself.
Yo soy el hombre en la relación. ¿Tú crees que tú me puedes controlar?
Look at this. You think you can control me? It's not like that. There you go. Ain't no real man finna deal with that shit, bro. Ain't no real man finna deal with that shit. And this is why you have a lot of these women that are going through it, you know, damn left, you know, to the damn wolves, getting passed around like a damn blunt in the hood. All right? It says, you think you can control me. It's not like that. And that's what women try to do, try to control you, when it's the other way around. The man is the head. You women are supposed to follow. I'm not interested in your money.
For the last 6-7 months, you have asked me for money. And I've tried to support you the best way that I can.
Dime qué cantidad de dinero.
Tell me what the amount is that I need to return. Look, he said, tell me what the amount is that I need to return. Okay?
Que tengo que devolvértelo y te lo voy a devolver.
I'll return it.
Dime cuánto que tú necesitas, que te lo voy a devolver.
I'll give it back. It ain't worth it, man. At that point, it ain't worth it no more. You know, you seem like he don't even want to deal with us no more. This is a breakup. Okay? We are witnessing a breakup, and he's saying, listen, whatever you want, I give back to you, because it ain't worth the headache, you know, the hassle, you know. Scriptures say, let me grab it, because you women, your role is to first of all be in order to the man. Well, first of all, if a man get a woman, let's read it. Ecclesiasticus or Sirach, chapter 36, verse 24. He that getteth a wife beginneth a possession. So if you get a wife, that's your possession. Not the other way around. Women say, my man. No. You're his woman. He's not your man. You're his woman. Okay? There's a difference in that. It says, he that getteth a wife beginneth a possession, which means you belong to him. He has a say over you, what you do, what you wear, where you go. He has a say in all that. And if you don't think you do, this is why a lot of women are fucking single. Okay, if you got a problem with that, this is why a lot of y'all ain't got a man now. It says, a help like unto himself. So you're supposed to be a help. Meaning there's no way a man should be cooking and cleaning if he got a woman. Nowadays, you meet a woman, she asks you, can you cook? Shows you how backwards this world is. This is why a lot of you women are going to be left out here to die. And a pillar of rest. You're supposed to be a pillar of rest. A man supposed to be able to come home and you know, kick his feet up and relax after a long day of working. And you're supposed to be able to, you know, have his food made, you know, have a bath rant, you know, hey, rub his back, his feet. And those of you brothers that have that, amen, that's the Lord blessed you. Okay, now, these women ain't, you know, perfect, but, you know, just for a woman to be a help, Lord blessed you, man. It says, where no hedge is, there the possession is spoiled. So where there's no hedge, where there's no man, the possession is spoiled. And he that hath no wife will wander up and down mourning. Yeah, because he got to do all this shit on his own. Okay, you need help. That's what women were created for, to be a helpmeet. You know, Eve was created to be a help unto Adam. Not Adam created to be a help unto Eve. And Adam came first, not Eve.
Think this is about, then I think you're still confused on the bigger problem.
Confundida está tu corazón.
So you're the one that's confused, sweetheart, because even though I'm Dominican,
que a pesar de que yo soy dominicano, tú piensas que yo no.
You think you can get that amount of money? You think I can't get that amount of money?
Conseguir esa cantidad de dinero. Al contrario. El dominicano.
Dominicans work much harder than gringos. Yep. Yeah, they gonna work.
Baja muchísimo más pesado que los gringos. Tú no lo sabías eso.
You didn't know that.
The f*** is a gringo.
Tú.
I haven't watched this whole video, but he said, what the fuck is a gringo? Which is a so-called white person. An Edomite. He said, you're a gringo. Wow.
Hey, gringa.
Passport
system. Hey, you saw the way she walked, turned around and walked away, man. One more video. And this one is a lot worse than the other ones. Well, let's play it anyways for edification's sake, man. You see this woman. It says, meanwhile, Stella seems to be struggling, trying to get her groove back. Passport sisters, hashtag passport sisters, hashtag passport bros. My comment says, disgusted faces, fucking through. So this woman right here, let's see what she got to say. And like I said, get your kids, hey man, first of all, this ain't for kids, no way. For this video, get your kids out the room. You know, put your headphones in or something. But listen to her disgusting mouth.
I have to eat pussy. Get me out of Jamaica, because these niggas said they don't eat pussy, and his lady don't respect him if you want him to eat pussy. Ziggy Marley, that's why you paddling alone. Because you're not eating pussy! You rather stay.
So she said, and he said, and we choose to stay. That's why you didn't go where you came from, and we'll rather stay here, okay? But you see how she's upset and screaming at these men because they don't want to lick her fish box, okay? You done came over there with 300 bodies, and you mad because nobody want to lick you where you probably don't even wipe right, you know, and I heard this too, and you know, Jamaica, they don't do that shit in Jamaica, man. I know this Jamaican Jake, you know, Benjamin, but he ain't in the truth. But he told me that. He said, you know, Jamaicans don't do that. You know, they don't do that over there. It's nasty. You know, which I don't blame them. You know, it's not something that you just, you know, do. You know, especially nowadays, you know, you get a woman, she's supposed to be a virgin. Nowadays, these women, shit, hey man. They all over the internet with all different kinds of men, okay? You get a damn STD on your damn tongue, man. It's disgusting. But she actually upset about this and making a fool of herself.
Yeah, to eat pussy. Why then you don't want a green card?
Eat some pussy and get a green card. Eat some pussy,
Get me out of Jamaica, cause
she said, "Get me out of Jamaica." She came over there to get somebody a green card, so she's trying to be a passport sister. She's trying to get somebody a green card, but because they don't pass that criteria of eating all them, you know, catfish, it's a problem. You see, so this place is just through, man. At the end of the day, this place is through. And this is another reason why these women are probably getting put to death over there. You see the spirit she in? Screaming at grown ass men like that. You see the spirit she in, man? Scripture just says she not supposed to usurp authority all over a man. Ain't no real man, no real grown ass man is gonna allow a woman to talk to him or treat him like that. He'll probably go across your motherfucking head, you know, and rightfully so. You women are out of order, and you're gonna get in order very, very soon, or you're gonna get left here, man. And majority of y'all gonna get left here. All right, the Lord ain't gotta save all so-called black women. All right, and really we don't need all you black women, man. Okay, shit, we can make more of you, you know, through the other tribes and the other nations. Believe it or not, believe it or not. So. And the Lord has really done a number on these women, man. The ones in America, He has really done a number on them. And this is why we need salvation. We need deliverance. You know, there's this tension between the man and the woman because of it. Also, ultimately goes back to what Esau did. You know, go read those Willie Lynch letters. But this is Isaiah chapter 4 verse 1. It says, "And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, 'We will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by thy name.'" So these women, they're going to come and see, they're going to get in their right mind. They're going to be humbled. And seven women shall take hold of one man. Nowadays, it's only me. You supposed to worship me. You supposed to simp for me. Yada, yada, yada. But the time we coming into you women are going to simp for the man. And not any man, but a man of the Lord. It says, in 7 days, seven women shall take hold of one man. So seven of these women, which seven means completion. It could be seven. It could be 10. 20, you know, 50, 100, shit. However many men can take care of that in that time. It says, "Shall take hold of one man, saying, 'We will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel.'" Nowadays, when you meet a woman, she wants you to take her shopping. She wants you got to take her on 5 dates before you even get the, you know. It says, "Only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach." Okay, so how does a woman be called by a man's name? Through marriage and sex is marriage. All right, so. Let's continue on. But you, amen. You see, you know that this ain't working out. This ain't working out, man. All right, this ain't working out. It's only going to get worse, and to the point where you know, something's gonna have to give, and you women gonna find out that you need a man a lot more than he needs you. All right. Let me grab this. She's screaming out all on the beach and shit, man. Sickening. Absolutely sick. He said, We'd rather stay here. They weren't going for her, man. And she a fairly good looking woman. But the problem is her spirit ain't good. You know, her spirit don't look too good, man. She ain't right in the head. Alright, and nobody want to deal with that. Let me grab this. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 32, verse 2. It says, "And a man shall be a hiding place from the wind," which means the destruction. So this is why you women gonna cleave to the men. Not because, you know, they need a green a green card, or, you know, not because they eat, you know, catfish. No, you're going to cleave unto a man for protection, man. The time we're coming into, hey, it's going to be on and popping. Okay? It says, "And a man shall be as a hiding place from the wind and a covert from the tempest, as rivers of water in a dry place, as the shadow of a great rock in a weary land." So if you imagine rivers of water in a dry place, you know, if you're in the desert, you ain't had nothing to drink, and you've been, you know, in that beaming sun for days, if not hours, you know, or hours, if not days, Then your mindset is you know, I need some water. And if you've seen water, if you see, you know, river of crystal clear water, nice and cool. You think you're going to go over there and take a sip? You think you're going to go over there and you know, ask for a damn water test? No, you're going to go over there, you're going to jump in it, you're going to dance in it. You know, you're going to drink it, you're going to, you know, bathe in it. You know, so that's the same way you women are going to be when you find a man of the Lord in that day. Okay, or it says, as a shadow of a great rock in a weary land. If it's very, very hot, you're going to go, you know, under the shadow of a great rock to get some shade. It's going to be a lot cooler and more comfortable under that rock versus, you know, out there, you know, in the damn sun. So, yeah, I didn't want to make this too long, so I'm kind of talking kind of fast. I want to speed it up so I can get on to some other videos. But, yeah, man, this is actually, you know, very sickening, you know, and you know, hey, there's a reason for everything, man. So I kind of put these three videos together to show you that, you know, first of all, that these women are going over there. The passport sisters are going over there and getting put to death, okay? And this last video shows you why, okay? Probably going to run their mouth, thinking they can, you know, rule over a man, use that feminine shit on a man in another country. Hey, they will bury your ass in the backyard, okay? And that's what they're finding out. And that's ultimately come humming back. You women are going to get an order, or you're going to get, you know, put back in, you know, the spirit world. Okay? Whatever said, I'm going to say shalom. Kwame Sharala of Baba Ba. Prayer lessons has been edifying to the whole fellow. Shalom.